This right here is the Eve Spectrum, a 27-inch gaming monitor with a 4K resolution and 144Hz refresh rate that looks fantastic on the outside, performs really well, and it comes with a pretty reasonable price for its specs. But there is a lot more to this Kickstarter project that you need to know and that you need to consider before ordering one for yourself. So, if you are in the market for a brand new 4K gaming monitor, keep on watching. This video is brought to you by Corsair and their new HS80 RGB wireless gaming headset. The HS80 offers everything you would want as a gamer, including great audio with plenty of bass, Dolby Atmos support, a sleek design with a very comfortable fit and a long battery life so you can easily game for hours without any interruptions, and a microphone quality that is actually good. Whether you like to game on a PC or you prefer your PlayStation consoles, the HS80 will be an excellent choice for both. Check it out using the links in the description below. It is packaged very neatly, accessories are in separate compartments and labeled properly, plus they also included a nice list of all the early backers of the project, which is even more cool if you are one of them and your name is actually on that list. What I found really interesting is that the stand is sold separately for the price of $100 or 100 euros. So, if you plan on vase mounting your monitor, you don't actually need to buy a stand. But if you do decide to go for the stand, you won't be disappointed because it is one of the nicest, cleanest, well-manufactured stands I've ever seen on a monitor. It is all steel, it is solid and sturdy, it looks very elegant, and it doesn't take much space on your desk. It is height adjustable with a very decent range. You can tilt it and rotate in 90 degrees, but you cannot swivel the display left or right. The chassis design is equally impressive. It is sleek, solid, and just looks very well done both on the front and on the back. The bezels are slim, there's no obnoxious branding anywhere, there's no big plastic chunks to make it look more gamey, nor lots of RGB that you won't be able to see anyway. Now, there's a great range of connections as well. You get one display port, two HDMI 2.1 ports, and a USB Type-C with a display port support. And next to that, you get another USB Type-C port and two Type-A ports, as well as an audio jack. They did go with a pretty large external power brick that's a bit annoying to cable manage, but I guess it is understandable as they've added up to 100 watts of power delivery on the Type-C header, which means you can charge and use your laptop using one single cable and then have your game PC, a PS5 and an Xbox Series X connected next to it, which is pretty cool. Exact charging speeds will vary per laptop. My MacBook Pro was charging at around 40 watts, while the Dell XPS 17 hit the advertised 90 to 100 watts. You control the OSD using a typical joystick on the back that is easily reachable and very easy to use. And the OSD itself is very responsive and very clean, and they went quite far to make monitor enthusiasts happy with a fully controllable overdrive settings and backlight strobing presets for various refresh rates. But how good is the actual panel? When it comes to color, it covers the complete sRGB color spectrum and 94% of the DCI-P3 spectrum, making it a solid option for many color-sensitive workflows, which I think is very important combined with its 4K resolution as it makes it more than just a gaming monitor. Color calibration is excellent out of the box as well, with a default P3 mode displaying some of the best factory results I've ever seen. There is also an sRGB mode, which really is well-tuned as well. The color temperature sits close to 6500K target, the gamma curve looks good, and basically everything suggests that you can just dive into your creative work without any additional manual calibration. Of course, since this is an IPS monitor and it uses an LG IPS panel without a full array local dimming backlight, contrast isn't amazing, but it is in line with other proper IPS monitors. It does have excellent viewing angles, of course, and the backlight bleed seems non-existent, and the uniformity of the panel is excellent as well, at least on my sample right here. It's also very bright, going up to 445 nits in SDR mode, which is plenty, even in a super light environment, and the minimum brightness is a bit higher than average, standing at 74 nits, but that should be low enough to game even in a completely dark room. It just looks great, it feels great from the moment you plug it in, and whether you mostly game, watch movies, or use it for productivity, it just looks stunning. Especially with the extra sharpness that you get with a 4K resolution on a 27-inch panel, compared to the more popular 1440p alternatives. But more pixels is not always better. You will need a powerful GPU to run games at this resolution, ideally an RTX 3080 or something along those lines. And a high DPI means that you might need to use scaling in some games and apps. And not to forget, the 1440p alternatives will be much cheaper. In the end, it kind of depends really on what you want to do with this monitor. The 4K resolution is fantastic for photo and video editing, and assuming you have a high-end GPU, games will just look amazing. Any immersive action-adventure game or an RPG will just clearly look better than on the 1440p resolution. And even if you prefer shooters, the Spectrum would be a good choice because when it comes to speed, it is actually less than 3 milliseconds behind the 360Hz ROG PG259QNR, around 1 millisecond behind the 1440p Aorus Fi32Q, and more importantly, it is around 6 milliseconds faster than the Gigabyte M32U, which is another fairly affordable 4K 144Hz gaming monitor. Now, I don't expect anyone who is only into competitive gaming to look for a 4K panel, but if it's one of the things that you enjoy to do on your PC, you will be able to compete well enough. It is FreeSync and G-Sync compatible, which is really important for a 4K gaming monitor as it will help in some very heavy titles. But do keep in mind that the range starts at 48Hz with visible stutters under that. So you do want to run settings that keep your games above 48fps if you want your game to run smoothly. Now, most IPS gaming monitors are not really good at HDR, especially when you compare them to anything with an OLED display or anything with an expensive full array local dimming technology. So if you are used to that level of HDR experience, the Eve Spectrum will not be that impressive. However, when you compare it to most regular IPS gaming monitors, the HDR experience isn't actually that bad. Eve's 16 zone limited dimming doesn't really compare to OLED's per pixel dimming, but it is better than nothing, and the brightness in HDR mode does go up to a very solid 710 nits. Now, that is a bit less than advertised 750 nits, but that's still considerably better than most monitors in the graph, and it's bright enough to actually see a slight difference when you're playing an HDR game or watching HDR content. But the backlight strobing mode is not that impressive. Now, it does seem like they really put a lot of time and a lot of money into it, offering lots of tuning options and even working with blur busters to make it as good as it can be, but the end result is just not that comfortable no matter what setting I put it on. Now, I'm personally not that into backlight strobing modes to begin with, and I would just turn it off. But for those of you that do want to use it, you can look at the Eve strobe utility from Blurbusters that will let you fine-tune the strobing even further. Right now, you can only order this monitor directly from Eve for a price of $800 or 800 euros for the monitor without the stand, or 100 more with the stand. Now, keep in mind, Eve is saying that it will be sold at regular retail shops very soon, but it's not there just yet. So right now, you do need to think about things like shipping costs and possible extra fees that do depend on your region if you order directly from Eve. What you also need to know is that even though they're promising that any orders you place should be shipped this month, it is still technically a pre-order, and with that comes the usual pre-order risk. And I honestly think that that is where the main challenges lie for Eve. They have a bit of a history when it comes to their previous Kickstarter projects that left a lot of people with a very strong opinion about the brand. I will leave a couple of links in the description down below if you want to read a bit more about it. But the thing is, they do need to carry that baggage to every new project and prove themselves even harder to be able to regain trust and just rebuild their reputation. They need to make sure that monitors are available consistently. They need to show that they are mature enough to deal with all kinds of challenges like return policies, like fulfilling warranties, and so on. And even though it's too early to talk about that right now, this will be crucial if they want to survive long term. And I really do hope that they do succeed, because they did make a very, very good product here. With its clean design, great build quality, panel performance, factory calibration, and even the HDR performance, it is just a well thought of monitor that could hold a very high position on the market, especially with its price. I mean, it is not necessarily the cheapest option on the market, but it is pretty reasonable considering how much it can do and how well it does it. Now, that is all I have to say about it. So let me know in the comments down below, what do you think about this Eve Spectrum? And if you like this video and you want to see more content like this one, don't forget to subscribe to Tech Testers to never miss an upload. Bye guys, and see you in the next one.